My check, 1, 2, 3.
Yo, yippee-yay, yo. Ben Trimmer's back in the studio.
Ooh.
What's up? That's here on top of the dome. What's up?
He's actually fire.
He is not fire, a rapper.
Right? Fuck you, asshole. Yeah.
He's been like that guy? Like, he's like, I forgot
about him. But I'm not a rapper, though.
Super hot.
That little bit right there sounded like Will Smith singing for the Wild Wild West. And that Wild, that song he tried to do.
Well, isn't he rich and famous? Thank you.
Gonna work.
guys, we are back in the studio. We got a lot of things coming up for you this episode.
That's a shot. Remember I said whenever we say we were back?
Well, this is a studio now, so
yeah. It was a studio before too. Whenever we say we back, it's a shot.
Sorry, new year, new us.
Followers, you know he deserves a shot for that one.
Yeah, hell yeah, he does.
Nah. Sorry, man. We are back in the studio, so
gonna write this down.
We are motherfucking back in the studio.
At some point, someone's gonna do it.
Making the list right here. Shots owed. Eric, number one.
Motherfucking back in the studio. A lot of action this weekend. We're going to start off with what's happening around here before we get into the Premier League, which we like to dive into the most, obviously. So we'll go over a little bit of the RB Leipzig and Borussia game where I ate some humble pie and Tyler Adams did not get on the pitch. RB Leipzig hosted the Borussia. Borussia won that game 1-0. Did you guys have anything besides
the goal? Which was a phenomenal goal.
Yeah.
No.
Only thing I takeaways that I got from this game was that it was a pretty even game. Leipzig did have slightly of the higher chance, but didn't capitalize. Borussia came and took the W and took the 3 points. Speaking of Barcelona, they cheated today again.
Agree. No, they did not cheat.
But they were at home. They paid the refs.
VAR was trash. The goalies.
No. It wasn't VAR. It was the. I
want to talk about that.
Every goal is reviewed.
That's what I want to confirm. Every goal is reviewed?
Yes.
So the ref was the one who chose.
He didn't go for review. They should have told them to do it.
Every goal is reviewed. There's a time to time given.
It was definitely reviewed.
Either the VAR ref said, look at it, he didn't look at it, or the VAR ref didn't say shit, and he just kept going with the game. Because they're not going to tell him anything. He's not going to look at it.
The crazy part is that the video part of the video system referee was correct. Everybody saw. He clearly got the goalie.
I missed the initial foul. I saw the replay
Quick breakdown. Messi comes across the box, takes his left footed shot, going upper 90. Keeper makes a phenomenal save.
Amazing.
Pops it up in the air. He falls to the ground. He's up, turning up to catch it. Both hands in the air in front of him. Suarez, it's a 50-50 with the goalkeeper. Suarez is coming in. And literally on the edge of his hands, that's where the ball is. Suarez ends up kicking the goalie's right hand into his shoulder and then kneeing his face, and then the follow through, he gets the ball. It sounds bad. It wasn't terrible. The goalkeeper was fine.
It was bad,
but the goalkeeper
had to be substituted out.
I saw you get taken off.
It wasn't terrible. It wasn't
a knee to the face. Not bad.
If he could walk off, he was
fine.
If he could walk off, he was fine. It wasn't like he kicked him in the face. It was a follow through. The goalkeeper's going to be fine.
Hey, chill.
Let me continue. The point is that everybody saw it. Every video review besides the video assistant ref saw that it was a foul, and they called it a goal. And it ruined the game for me, to be honest, as a Barcelona
fan. Well, that's what they were saying, that Barcelona was kind of upset. They weren't happy with that win. Like, they were like,
We got the 3-1, which was excellent, because okay, you could say, yeah, but no. Like, they were playing defensive.
Didn't it come, like, in a stoppage time?
No, it didn't. It was towards the end of the game.
It was 5 minutes after Messi came in, right? That goal happened.
Yeah,
yeah, and that was they were tied before that.
No. I'm saying the third goal.
All right. This was a nice goal too. This is my point of view. Like, the thing is, they were playing defensive. The fact that the goal went in forced them to become an attacking team, trying to get the tying goal, which opened up their defense, which therefore caused a third goal. My point is that missed opportunity where you actually have a chance to correct it. Was failed, and it fucking cost Leganés the game. It's bullshit. It shouldn't have happened.
And I think it's because of that the ref allowed other shit to happen. Like, the goalkeeper, he grabbed the ball from the air. He came in, and then Suarez was in front of him. He shoved Suarez out of the way when he was running. Shit like that. Like, it just got out of his hands.
But I don't know how this can get out of your hands.
Those things can get out of your hands, but when you put this new system into a league that's supposed to correct all these errors, and everybody's, oh, yeah, VAR, some players are against it, other players aren't in favor of it, or some are, shouldn't you be using it?
That's expectation.
So what is VAR then? What's the point of VAR?
If they're not using it, there's no point for it. Why use it? Why have it then?
Exactly.
Why pay all this money if you're not going to use it? Use it. It's there for a reason.
And the insane part is that if that was reviewed during the World Cup with the World Cup refs, they would have called it off.
Well, that's why everybody loved it, because it was really well used. It was
very well used.
What kind of scares me, though, is that this may be a common thing with VAR.
Not being used?
Not when it's not used and it's a blatant thing. It's like, come on, man, what the fuck? This is obviously a complete speculation, but I feel like it's going to become a common thing.
Now, here's a little bit of a bias, and any guys listening out there, if you follow any other teams other than the major ones that we follow, let us know. Has this issue happened in other games, in other teams? Because right now, everybody's going to say, oh, it's because it's Barcelona, and they're favored. Well, we don't know that.
Does this
ref have a record of not making calls against, you know, teams like the 14th and the 17th place teams when they play each other? You know what I mean? Just that we don't watch those games. We don't know. But this was it came down to a 50-50. I thought it was fair that Suarez went for it, but he got the goalkeeper, so it's a foul. It's not a goal.
It comes to the point, as a player, I'm assuming, because I've never been in that position, that you realize that you're not going to be able to make it. So shouldn't you kind of stop yourself?
It was too fast.
I guess would have been his best action afterwards is to be a good sportsman.
And call it off. But you know what's crazy? It's actually happened in history. It has happened in history. And the ref said no. It's still a goal.
Yeah.
Well, it's like for pens.
It's a law. It's a law. Like, a goal is a goal. But at least, you know, show the good sportsmanship. But Suarez, you don't expect it from ever at all.
Yeah, you hate him so much.
Well, he's more than alone. So other than that, any takeaways from the game?
Messi is so important for that team. It's insane. I watched the whole game. I was excited to see him on the bench. I'm like, all right, let's see what happens. And I saw that they need him. He changed the game. Mm.
Did you see Dembele play?
No, Dembele was a spark of...
Yeah, but now he's hurt.
Now he's hurt. But this game, Dembele, fucking phenomenal.
But he's not Messi.
He was phenomenal.
But at least you can see the quality in the player.
Look.
And at least with him, you guys can have a brighter future. He's a really, really good player.
He was very, very exciting to watch. He had some great plays, but there was no interplay. And when you see Jordi Alba and Messi linked together, that's how the third goal happened. But that's my point. Without Messi, there was no chemistry. And these guys practice together in and out. If it doesn't revolve around Messi, it's not linking. Dembele's practiced with them all season, almost 2 years now, and there wasn't that chemistry. There should be more chemistry, and there wasn't. So what's going to happen? What's going to happen when Messi gets hurt or Messi leaves or Messi retires? We're fucked.
Also, Leesby is pretty old, too.
There isn't something else I want to talk about, but I think we'll get into that a little bit later. More about Coutinho and all the dramas that are going on behind him. Yeah, yeah. But we'll save that for another transfer to discussion that we're going to have.
Just reminding me.
Ricky should be excited about that one. Word is he's going to Manchester United, or at least rumors, but...
Yeah. We'll see.